Ready.
Okay, first skit is called One Day Is Like.
Hey, God.
Yes, my child?
You know the Bible says that one day with you is like 1,000 years?
Yes.
Is that true?
Well, it's more like the blink of an eye.
Really?
Yes, you see, I created time. I exist on a different level.
Wow, so 1,000,000 years would be more like...
1 second.
That's amazing. Well, what about money?
What do you mean?
Well, that's nothing to you either, is it?
Not really. My streets are paved with gold.
So $1,000,000 is more like...
$1.
Really?
Yes, it makes no difference to me.
Wow, so God, could you spare me $1?
Is that your clever way of asking me for $1,000,000?
Well, yes, Lord.
Okay.
You said okay.
Yes, okay.
You mean that?
Of course I do.
Wow, so God is actually going to give me $1,000,000.
Now, just give me 1 second.
Gary. Okay.
Action.
Within our words, there is a hidden power of motion.
The tongue is a small thing, but a tiny spark can set a great forest on fire.
Once spoken, our words begin blazing a trail through the hearts and lives of those around us.
One kind word can demolish guilt and inspire hope.
But the same words have also embraced hatred and executed innocence.
Once spoken, our words scorch through feelings and emotions on a level only they can produce.
Your words set up a chain of events beyond your control and which you would never know.
One word can destroy beliefs, harden hearts, or cultivate hatred.
But they can also demonstrate faith, display forgiveness, and at the end, nurture love.
The power of life and death lies in a single word.
And we, the image of God, have this great power in one word.
How are your words affecting others?
When was the last time someone spoke to you?
One word.
And made your day.
Good. Hang up to that for the next one. Okay, so you ready? Yeah, we're just going to skip. She knows when to come in. That's probably the script right there.
Hey, God. I have a problem. So, my BFF Karen was invited to Julie's party, but I wasn't. And I just don't know how I'm gonna deal with this rejection.
Well, why don't
you? You know, like, everybody's gonna be there, except for me. That's so lame. Such a loser.
You might just...
I'm gonna text Karen and ask her if she, what's this? Hey, Julie invited me to your party. It means I can go after. Wait, I have to get dressed. I don't have to talk to you, God. Bye.
You're welcome. You're welcome. What's up, God? How are you today?
I'm good. How about you?
Well, everything should be great, but it isn't. My band, you probably never heard of us. We're called the Raging Rats. That's Rats with 2 T's. Well, anyhow, we're going on tour with a bunch of really cool bands, and there's going to be like 400 people there. It's going to be epic.
So, what's the problem?
Hey, I just need your help. See, I get nervous on stage, and last night it was really bad. I broke a guitar string, and I couldn't finish my solo. I just couldn't finish.
But couldn't you have...
No, I couldn't. You see, it was so bad I just walked off stage, and it almost made me cry. That's not cool, man.
Well, I mean, you could.
But anyhow, you just got to give me your support and follow me on MySpace, Facebook, find me on YouTube, stalk me on Twitter. Please do that, okay? Bye, God.
Twitter?
Hi, God.
Hey.
How are you doing?
Well, I'm
well,
just...
Well, this week is like the biggest game of the season. I mean, this is a championship game. State championship. Can you believe that?
Believe?
Do you know how proud the team would if we could win that? The whole school would be proud, the whole town, everyone in the church.
Oh, I'm proud.
But I don't know. I mean, everyone's counting on me to be the best. And I can't do it at all. I have to have some help from my teammates. And I don't think they're ready for it. What do you think, God?
Well,
I don't really know, but I really need your help and support. Be with us and help us to win. Will you do that for us, God?
Yes, I
don't know, but I mean me personally. I go to school, go home, go to practice. Then go home, go to sleep, and then do it all over again. School, practice, sleep. School, practice, sleep.
Why don't you...
And then in my way to get stronger, so I put up in the post and make the moves. I mean, it's all about basketball in the age 24/7. God, this is my dream to win today. You have to help me.
I will.
Well, I don't know, God, but the game is coming up in a few days, and I have to go to practice right now. So I will see you later, God. Bye.
See you at the game.
God, I really need your help. I just don't know what to do.
What's wrong?
Well, school is just so hard. I'm making so many mistakes doing everything on my own.
Well, I'm here for you.
I know.
I'll always, always be here for you. Through the good times and through the bad. I'm your father.
Yeah, I know, but there's so much I have to do. I have to buy my books, I have to pay for rent, I have to eat. Whenever I go home on weekends, they want me here and there.
Shush.
And I haven't slept in only you know how long.
Shush.
Plus I have exams and I've got to do
kids. Shush, shush.
God, excuse me? Are you shushing me?
Look, Miranda, I never intended you to live your life this way. I never intended you to be so busy, people running here, running there, and not being able to take time to sit and talk to me, worship. That's not how you're supposed to live your life. I never meant it to be that way.
You're right. I'm sorry, God. You know, it's just me and you here. Would you mind if I sing you a song just for you?
You know, that would make me very, very happy.
Listen to God. Don't just talk and then run. Okay? Have a great day, guys. Hope you
okay, sorry you have to run. That's too bad.
God's going to run.
Leave God in here, though. We're going to leave God in here.
All right.
Everybody else can run.
We went next door to Mrs. McAfee.
I missed this class.
Good job, Roman.
Thank you.
Good job. Did good.
Thank you.
Did good, Haley.
Mr. Cap.